Hey everyone, TorqueMoD here. So this is a follow-up to my tutorial on how to combine FBX animation files in 3D Studio Max, but this time I'm going to show you guys how to actually do it inside of Unreal Engine 4. So for those of you who have FBX files, but you don't have a copy of 3D Studio Max, you can still use Unreal 4, which happens to be free, to get basically the exact same results. So how we're going to do that is I've already opened up my project in Unreal 4, and you can see with my werewolf character, I've already got multiple animation files. So this werewolf was one that I downloaded, purchased on the Unreal Marketplace, and it already comes with a whole host of animations. Now, the really cool thing is that you can actually combine these animations using an animation montage, and then you can record them as a new FBX file. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to go to wherever your animations are stored. So in my case, they're in the werewolf animations, and here you can see a list of all the different animations. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create our montage, which is going to allow us to combine those animation files together. So you can right-click in the empty space, and you go to the animation category here, and we're going to choose animation montage. And then it's going to ask you for a skeleton. So we're going to search for werewolf and choose that as our skeleton. Now we're going to call this, instead of new, I'm going to call this werewolf attack right left. Actually, just attack right left montage. And then we're going to double click that. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up to where our attack animations are. And so we've got our attack left and our attack right. So we're going to drag these into the default section here, just below the default. So we're going to drag in attack right, and then we're going to drag in attack left, and you'll see that they'll show up in the timeline. So now, when you scrub the timeline, you can see that they're showing up there. And they're just going to keep repeating. Now, normally, when you're creating a montage, you would actually create sections and put all that together. But for the sake of actually just combining our animation files, this is all we have to do. We just drag them into the montage group. And then we can hit the record button. So we're going to hit the two front button here. It doesn't seem to be working. I think it's because there's nothing in our timeline, but that's fine. Then we're going to hit the record button, and it's going to ask where we want to put our new animation. So I'm going to choose werewolf animations, and we're going to call this werewolf attack right left combine, and the previous one was werewolf attack right left combine montage, because the montage name was already in there when we created the new montage. So just make sure you're not using the same file name, otherwise you'll have an issue. You could go combine and then anim if you want to. We're going to hit OK. And this is recording. You can see that we're already recording. Don't worry, we're going to have some empty space. Now we're going to hit the play button, which is actually a pause button. And it's going to play those two animations probably multiple times. And then we're going to hit stop recording. And what this has done is you'll see werewolf attack right left combine anim has been successfully recorded. And you'll actually see that show up in your animation list. Let's see, attack right left combine anim. It's got the one with the asterisks on it. So we're going to double click that, and here we'll see that we have a lot of empty space, and then it plays our attack animations until I hit the stop record button. and then it goes for more empty space. Now, the way we get rid of the empty space is we simply scrub our timeline until we see the first little frame of movement. So, right about there. So, what we're going to do is we're actually going to hit the two previous, and that just allows us to nudge a single frame forward and two next. So, we're going to hit two next until we actually see his hand move. There we go. And then we're going to go one frame back to previous. So, this is where the animation starts. So, once we've got our little red cursor there, we're just going to right click and you're going to see an option remove frame 0 to frame 302. So, that's all the empty space. So, we're going to choose that option and that'll set our starting point. And then we want him to attack once, attack a second time. And then we gotta find the exact moment where it switches between the two here. So that's probably right there. And then because of the fact that I know that each animation is 30 frames long, so we should have a total of 60 frames. However, you'll notice that this is 61. Because those are going from 0 to 30, that's actually 31 frames each. So we're actually, we want 62 frames for our total, and that's where it's going to end. So I just use the 2 next button because I had stopped, you know, at 61.16 or whatever. You just hit the 2 next and it goes to the next whole frame. And now we're going to right click and choose remove from frame 63 to 185, and that'll get rid of the extra at the back. So it helps to know the exact length of your two animation files. So now that I've actually got that, and it's working perfectly, what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose save, and I'm going to show you guys how you can actually find out the length of an animation inside Unreal. So if we look at attack left here, you'll see current frame 0 out of 29. Oh, so I was actually wrong. It thinks that there's only 29 frames here, which is interesting because inside 3D Studio Max, these are actually 30 frames, which makes 31. But this is saying that it's 29 frames, and attack right should also be 29 frames. Interesting, interesting. So we've got a little bit of empty space according to Unreal. But if we look at our attack right left combine, let's see if we nudge. Yeah. So we have one extra frame in both. Because you'll see when I nudge forward to next, it's still no frame. So we're going to crop that too. So we're going to right click, remove from frame one. Oh, sorry. That's not what I wanted to do. Right click. You don't want to remove from frame 1 to frame 60. So re-zero at frame 0 is actually, because it's only one frame, it's just going to knock that one frame out. There we go. And then we will scroll to the end and we'll step back with two previous and make sure that that is okay. So that should be it. It's now perfectly cropped. You can save that, but the beautiful thing here is if you want to open this in your favorite animation editor of choice, like Blender, which is a free one, you can actually, once you've combined those files, you can actually right click on it and choose export to FBX, and now you actually get a combined FBX file, the same way that we ended up with one in our 3D Studio Max tutorial. So this is incredibly versatile. It's a little bit more complicated because you end up with a little bit of empty space at the beginning of the end by using the record option. But hey, it's a free way to combine as many FBX files as you want. And the really nice benefit here too is that the Unreal, when you're combining with an anim montage, it'll actually blend the animations together here. So if we were to want him to attack right, attack left, and then die, you'll see that he'll do If we scrub our timeline, he'll do an attack right, attack left, and then blap, he keels over dead. But the nice thing is it'll actually add in blending when you're recording. So that's something that you don't get by combining the FBX files inside 3D Studio Max. You don't get that nice blend, whereas Unreal, it'll automatically blend between the animations for you. So it's actually even better than using 3D Studio Max. So there you have it, guys. That's a quick way to combine FBX files using Unreal Engine 4. Hopefully this video has helped you out. If it has, please be sure to hit the like button and also subscribe for future tutorials. Thanks a lot.